we have to set it up in a certain position in order to get that reflection. This is without the light bouncer, and this is with the light bouncer. Ooh. This is a custom-made backdrop I use for filming. I pretty much just taped a piece of white paper on this foam board. If you add another light source on top of the object, it will cast a lot of shadow. But sometimes if you want that more dynamic lighting situation, this is what you can do. So this is with the LED lamp light on, and this is without the lamp. Whenever I want the background to be brighter and, you know, stand out more, I will usually have two light sources on both sides. So these are all the settings. I usually have it on the green one, Scene Intelligent Auto, because I'm just lazy, but sometimes I also use this mode. It really depends on the sculpture I'm taking picture of. If I'm only taking picture of the face of my sculpture today, I'll turn it on portrait mode after I import the picture in Lightroom. I kind of want to change the hue of the yellow. Can you see the difference? Because I feel like the gold in the original picture is a little too yellow. I want to give it a more like copper orangey tone. My favorite part is brush in Lightroom. For example, I only want to change her face, right? So I'm going to tap on her face and paint only her face and neck. So I'm only modifying this area where I painted. For example, I feel like the face is too bright. I can bring down the exposure a little bit, but normally I would bring down the highlights and bring up the haze just to give it more dimension before, after.